Good morning, students. How are you? I hope all of you are fine and safe at your home. Today, we are going to start with a new interesting lesson, The Living World. In the photo in front of you, which is also in your textbook on page number 9, you can see there are some things. Can you spot out the things? Correct. There is a house, there is a girl, there is a boy, kite, puppy, chickens, ball, boxes, buckets, and many things are there in present in the picture. From them, some of them are living things while some of them are non-living things. Can you identify which of them are the living things while which are not living things? Again, you are correct. The girl, boy, tree, chicken, hen, puppy, these all are the living things. While ball, kite, box, bucket, these are the non-living things. So our environment is made up of living things as well as non-living things. How are we going to differentiate between the living as well as non-living things? We differentiate them on the basis of their characteristics. Now we are going to see the characteristics of living things. There are many kinds of plants and animals around us. They show some similarities and some differences. Yet, with the help of certain features, we can tell that they are all living things. These features are not seen in the non-living things. Such features are said to be the characteristics of living things. Let us study these characteristics. So, in this lesson, we are going to study about the characteristics of living things. How you can differentiate between the living and non-living things. Let us study about the first characteristic, that is growth. In the picture, what differences do we see between the young ones and the adults? We can see that a baby grows up to become an adult person, woman or a man. During the period of its growth, the baby gains in height, weight as well as strength. In the same manner, all animals grow into adults in a certain period. Each animal takes different time to grow. Generally, we humans require 18 to 21 years for its growth. Here, there is a small activity for you people. During this quarantine period, you can enjoy yourself with this activity. In the image, you can see there are two plants. In one plant, there is a stretched thread. It is tied to the plant and to some hook. In the second plant, that thread is loose. So what has happened? This plant has grown taller. In all plants, it is mainly the width and height of the stem that grows. As they grow, some plants develop branches while some plants do not. So there is a difference in growth in the plants also. Though all living things grow, animals grow only for a certain period, while plants, they grow as long as they live. Isn't this a fun fact about the plants? They grow as long as they live. Here, you can see in the image the difference between the growth in a banyan tree and a coconut tree. The banyan tree has grown widthwise, while the coconut tree has grown lengthwise. So the growth of living thing, they occur from within the body, which means that it occurs in all the parts of the body, in animals as well as the plants. Food is necessary for growth. For growing, we need an important factor, and that important factor is food. Plants, they make their own food in sunlight. Plants produce food from the water, nutrients in the soil, and the carbon dioxide present in the air. These are the three main necessary things for plants to make their food. This process takes place in the leaves of plants. We prepare our food in the kitchen. Like that only, leaves are the kitchen for plant. It is brought about in the presence of sunlight with the help of chlorophyll in the leaves. This process of food production is called photosynthesis. Now we are going to see photosynthesis in a diagrammatic representation. In this diagram, you can see there is sunlight, there are the leaves, Carbon dioxide is taken inside by the leaves. Water and nutrients are taken through the roots, and the plants, they leave out oxygen. So here you can see how is photosynthesis in the plant. Carbon dioxide is taken inside the leaves. In the presence of sunlight, there is chlorophyll in the leaves itself. Roots take the water and nutrients. The food is prepared. Plants get nutrition from that food, and oxygen is left out into the atmosphere through plants. This is known as photosynthesis. And have you ever thought, why are plants green? So plants, they get that green color due to chlorophyll in them. Animals, however, do not have chlorophyll. They do not produce their own food. Means we produce our own food, but not inside of our body. We search for food. Animals such as goats, sheep, horses eat grass, while wild animals like tigers and lions meet their need for food by hunting other animals which live on plants. We human beings, we survive on vegetables as well as other animals. We make our food in a different way. We cook our food from outside that we get. Animals do not prepare food inside our body. Thus, the intake of food and the resultant growth is an important characteristic in living things. Means what? Whatever food we take, according to that we grow. So growth is an important and the first characteristic of human being. Students, hold your hand in front of your nose or keep your hand on your chest. What do you feel? When you keep your hand in front of your nose, you feel the air coming out of your nose. Or if you keep your hand on your chest, we see movement in the chest. If we observe a sleeping dog, what we see? We see that its belly is moving. Its stomach is moving. Why does that happen? So our next characteristic is respiration. Living things need oxygen in order to live. Inhaling oxygen and exhaling the carbon dioxide formed in the body due to the use of oxygen is called respiration. So we take our air inside. When we take air inside, what we inhale is oxygen. And when we leave the air outside, we leave carbon dioxide into the atmosphere. This is known as respiration. Animals such as fish, snake, mouse, etc., they have specific organs for respiration. On the other hand, plants respire by means of microscopic pores on their stems and leaves. Thus, respiration is a characteristic of living thing. Like growth, respiration is the next characteristic of living things. In the diagram now, you can see a leaf of plant. On the leaf, there are some microscopic pores through which plants respire. Human beings, they respire through the nose. And the fish, they are having a special organ called gills for respiration. Like that fish, snake, mouse, they are having a special organ. This is respiration. Now students, tell me one thing. Is all the food we eat used by the body? What is the unused part of food converted into? So, our next characteristic of living things is excretion. Waste substances are formed during the many processes that take place in the bodies of animals. So, first we had asked a question, is all the food we eat used by the body? Or what is the unused part of food converted into? What is the answer? The answer is that all the food that we eat is not used by the body. Some of the food is formed into waste product, and that waste product is eliminated out of the body through the next characteristics, that is excretion. These waste products are called excreta, and the process of eliminating them from the body is called excretion. Animals have specific organs for excretion. So we animals, you all know, have a specific organs to throw away the waste from our body. While plants, they do excrete. They are also living things, so they must also excrete. They must also throw the waste out of their body. How do plants excrete? For example, some plants shed leaves in a specific season. Waste substances stored in the leaves of the plants are shed along with the leaves. This is one of the type how plants excrete the waste out of their bodies. Next, what you have to do is, there is a specific activity for you people. Again, one more fun activity. What you will do, take a transparent plastic bag, tie it over a leaf of a plant as shown in the picture. In the next picture, you will see how to tie the plastic bag over the leaf. Observe it after 6 to 7 hours. What do we see? We see droplets of water collected inside of the bag. What does that mean is, that means plants excrete water in the form of water vapor. So the plants, they excrete some of the water in the form of water vapor. Thus, we saw excretion is also a characteristic of living things. In today's video, we learned about the three characteristics of living things: growth, respiration, and excretion. We'll meet again in the next video. Till then, stay safe, stay happy.